Alarm Motion, setting up a motion grid. To navigate to the Alarm Motion menu, right-click to bring up the Quick menu and select Main menu from the bottom of the list, followed by Setup and then Alarm, then select Motion. As you can see, there are several different options. The leftmost column displays the number for the channel that you'll be configuring. The second column, Enable, will let you decide whether or not you want to enable or disable motion detection alarms for the selected channel. To enable motion detection alarms, ensure the box is checked. The next column, Holding Time, will let you determine how long the event will last. For example, if the alarm triggers and the holding time is set to 10 seconds, then 10 seconds of no motion will need to pass before the alarm event is over. If motion is detected within those 10 seconds, the alarm will continue. We're going to return to the fourth column in a moment, but for now, we're going to click the setting option in the area column. When you click the setting option in the area column, you'll be taken to a live view of your selected channel, only a bit different. You'll notice a blue grid over the screen. This is your motion grid. Defining your motion grid can be helpful in limiting false alerts, as will lowering the sensitivity on the sensitivity bar. A higher sensitivity will require less movement to trigger the motion alarm, whereas a lower sensitivity will require more significant motion to trigger the alarm. But sometimes lowering the sensitivity isn't enough. Since we're filming a public roadway, we're getting a lot of false alarms, so we want to remove that roadway from the motion grid. To remove the roadway from the grid, we're going to left-click and drag with the mouse to remove the blue squares. The motion grid will only trigger if movement is detected within the grid itself. Simply left-click on a square on the grid to remove it, or left-click in an empty space to add to the grid. The grid does not need to be connected. Select the Save icon next to the sensitivity slider to save your grid. Once you save your grid, you will return to the alarm motion screen. Selecting the setting button and the fourth column trigger will allow you to further customize the alarms. Select the buzzer option if you want an audible buzzer to emit from the DVR when motion is detected for that channel. If you'd like the monitor to display a specific channel when motion is detected, select that channel from the Show Full Screen drop-down menu. If you'd like to receive an email when motion is detected on this channel, select the email option. Email options can be configured in the network email screen. If you'd like the DVR to automatically record a snapshot of whatever is on the camera when motion is detected, select the snap option. The snaps can be found in the search image menu. Select OK to save your changes. And don't forget to apply those changes before exiting.